Good morning, everyone. Today we discuss about circulatory pathways. Circulatory pathways are two types: open type of circulatory system, closed type of circulatory system. Open type of circulatory system. In open type of circulatory system, heart pumps blood into the large vessels. These vessels opens into the large spaces, called sinuses, and then it enters into the heart. In closed circulatory system, the blood pumps into the network of the blood vessels, In open type of circulatory system, the blood is called hemolymph. Because there is no variation between the blood and extracellular fluid. So it is called hemolymph. In closed circulatory system, the variations present between the blood and extracellular fluid. The blood flows slowly. In open type of circulatory system, the blood flows fast in closed type of circulatory system. Open type of circulatory system is primitive type of circulatory system. Closed type is advanced type. Examples of open type: leeches, arthropoda, mollusca, echinodermata, hemichordata, urochordata, Examples of closed type: annelida, cephalopoda, and vertebrates. Examples are most important. Examples of open type of circulatory systems are leeches, arthropoda, mollusca, echinodermata, hemichordata, urochordata. Closed type examples: annelida, cephalopoda, and vertebrates. The variations present in the circulatory system of vertebrates, because the organisms of the lung breathing complete terrestrial organisms are evolved from gill breathing aquatic organisms. So these develops, single circulation pathway to double circulation pathway. The gradual changes present in the vertebrate hearts. In fishes, heart is tubular heart. In fishes, sinus, venosus and truncus arteriosus are present. Atria, one atria and one ventricle. Atria receives deoxygenated blood from the body parts. It enters into the ventricles. Ventricles distribute deoxygenated blood into the gills for oxygenation. Gills distributes oxygenated blood into the body parts. So fish's heart is called venous heart and bronchial heart. Venous means deoxygenate. Venous heart. Fish's heart receives and distributes only deoxygenated blood. Receives and distributes only deoxygenated blood. So, fish heart is called venous heart. Bronchial heart. Fish heart ventricles distribute only gills. Ventricles distribute blood only gills. So, fish's heart is called bronchial heart. Fish's heart is called bronchial heart. In fishes, only single circulation. Single circulation occurs in the fishes. Single circulation means blood enters into the heart only once in a single circuit. Single circulation means blood enters into the heart only once in a single circulation is called single circulation. Next, fishes, amphibians and reptiles. In amphibians, the chambers of heart is three chambered. Two atria and one ventricle. In reptiles, two atria and one incomplete ventricle, except crocodiles. Crocodiles has four chambered heart, completely divided ventricle present in the crocodile. In this right atrium, ventricles distribute blood into the body parts and respiratory organs. Right atria receives deoxygenated blood from the body parts. Left atria receives oxygenated blood from the respiratory organs. Respiratory organs are skin, lungs, gills. Right atria receives deoxygenated blood and left atria receives oxygenated blood. These two bloods are mixed in the ventricle. Ventricles distributes mixed blood into the body parts and respiratory organs. There is no separation between the oxygenated blood and the deoxygenated blood. So this circulation is called incomplete double circulation. Sinus venosus and conus arteriosus both are present in amphibians. only sinus venosus is present in reptiles. Conus arteriosus is absent in reptiles. Only sinus venosus is present in reptiles. Next, crocodiles, birds and mammals. Crocodiles, birds and mammals. In crocodiles, birds, mammals, the heart chambers are four chambers. Heart chambers are four chambers. Two atria and two ventricles. Lungs receives deoxygenated blood. Deoxygenated blood from right atrium. Left atria receives oxygenated blood from lungs. Left ventricle distributes Left ventricle distributes oxygenated blood into the body parts and right ventricle receives deoxygenated blood from the body parts. There is separation between the oxygenated blood and deoxygenated blood. The circulation of these organisms are called double circulation. Double circulation, complete double circulation present in the crocodiles, birds, mammals because of the complete septa present in the right ventricle and the left ventricle. This separates the oxygenated blood and the deoxygenated blood. In heart, right side of the right atria and the right ventricles are called pulmonary heart. Left atria and the left ventricles are called systemic heart. In fishes, single circulation present. In birds and mammals, double circulation pathway is present. Pulmonary circulation and the systemic circulation. Two circulations are present. So these are called double circulation. In systemic circulation, deoxygenated blood circulate in the pulmonary circulation and oxygenated blood flows in the systemic circulation. So, right atria and the right ventricles are called pulmonary heart. Left atria and the left ventricles are called systemic heart. In fishes, single pathway is present in fishes and it evolved into double circulation.